We walked into the chapel. We'd never been there before. And John handed out some music. And the first piece he handed to us was Morales Passi Mihi Domine. Suddenly, we were aware there was something else going on. And as I'm telling you now, I can still feel in my body that moment. Quite unawares, behind us, Jan had started joining in with us. Then Manfred got up from the pew and said, "We have to record this as soon as possible." And the other guys, I can tell you there were tears already in the eyes of people sitting there. And so that's how it started.
The countertenor David James, remembering the extraordinary first meeting between the Hilliard Ensemble and the Norwegian saxophonist Jan Garbarek, brought together in the monastery of St. Gerold in the Austrian Alps by Manfred Eicher.
I was shooting a film and I thought about the music for this movie. And I thought maybe it could be a combination of voices and Jan playing on top of it. And then the journey began because there was not so much musical concept before. We had to see how it works, and in this way the project developed.
The way I remember it, it was that the Hilliards took out some piece and started singing very casually.
Jan Garbarek.
I listened for 1 minute and then I joined in with my saxophone for another minute, and then we stopped and we looked at each other and said, "I think we are onto something."
Manfred Eicher sees this new Officium recording, Officium Novum, as the third installment in a testament documenting the relationship between these musicians who've grown together. David James again.
I certainly thought when we started performing with Jan in concerts that there was a sort of finite point we couldn't develop further. However, how wrong I've been. And now, really, when he performs us, it is like a fifth member of the group. And he knows us so well, and we know him so well, he can pick up on anything, and we feel completely free and relaxed.
Officium Novum is the third Officium release, and it's different again to the previous CDs. It feels like an hour-long prayer, an exquisite journey for the soul from the opening music, an arrangement by Comitas of an Armenian hymn for the baptism of Christ, to the closing music, a composition by Garbarek called We Are the Stars.
Yes, indeed, it is like prayers and hymns or hymns and prayers. That is because this material that is very Orient Occidental, I would say, like a slow movement of a camera coming from the east into the west, capturing all these influences. And I think how the album is now sequenced, it almost feels like a composition for the entire album from the beginning to the end. And I'm quite proud of this shape, actually.
The music of Armenia plays a big part in Officium Novum. Even the very opening resembles the plaintive sound of the ancient Armenian reed instrument, the duduk. There are quite a number of pieces by Comitas. How did you come across his music?
In a remote and ancient church, perched rather perilously on the edge of an enormous gorge of the river Kazakh, with distant views of Mount Aragats in this wild, slightly bleak Armenian countryside.
Gordon Jones of the Hilliard Ensemble.
We've been invited there by a Yerevan radio station to look at the traditional music of the Armenian church, the Sharakans, and to record them in this church. The music as you hear it now is in a early 20th century arrangement by Comitas Vardaped, who was a monk, musician and a musicologist. But it's in this version that the music is extremely well known to almost all Armenians.
Within the album, I think that's one of the most heart-stopping moments on the whole of ECM.
when you go from surb, surb into the arvo pet, and the sun comes out, that's absolutely magical.
It's the center of the album. From there, it's the second chapter, so to say, and we go and speed a bit into a different direction, you know, slowly encountering new landscapes again. You know, I think this piece is one of the wonderful compositions of Arvo.
Manfred Eicher's slowly rolling camera takes us through Russian liturgy, Spanish music which makes us smile, and Peritin, as well as the Armenian music of Komitas, and compositions by Garbarek which reflect his deep love of poetry. Jan, there are two of your own compositions. First of all, Alting Finns, with the words by Per Lagerkvist. Is he a poet you've been very close to for a long time?
For a very long time. I have some favorite books of poetry that seem to fall apart slowly, and this is one of them, you know. And of course, he's enormously important in Scandinavian literature. And I find a lot of resonance in his poems with my own thinking, and I just enjoy it very much. And this one came up. The name of the poem is actually The Dead One. So it says something about how everything remains except the unrest of the soul. That's the final word.
And when you were writing the music, you wrote it for yourself and the Hilliards?
Yes, as I usually tend to do when I write things, I write myself right out of it. I had a hard time fitting in, you know. After. But the aim was to try to convince these marvelous singers to give it a shot, and I was very, very lucky to have them oblige, you know, and do it.
How does this project fit in with the ECM ethos?
I don't know whether there's an ECM ethos. There's just an ethos of trying to discover music, and that was from the beginning the same. As far as I'm concerned, I like to find out what is possible. I like to discover music. I like to explore music, and I like to dive into music. For me, music is like maybe it sounds pathetic, but it's like a nourishment. It's like water and bread, and that's what it is. That's my ethos, is to find out and present the music with a personal approach to the public, and they can decide. And it's an ongoing kind of process to find out.